Hello, welcome to Fabtech 2022. Dan Davis of the Fabricator Magazine here. I'm in the Mitsubishi Laser booth, and I'm joined by Ryan Conroy, and we're going to talk about the new 12-kilowatt GXF120. And Ryan, what are some of the things about this laser that metal fabricators might find interesting?
Yeah, so I'd say the GXF is packed full of features aimed at increasing overall productivity. But I'd say the most prominent is going to be our artificial intelligence. So with AI, the machine's actively listening to and monitoring the cutting process in real time. And based off of its reading, if we're, let's say, getting bad cutting, the machine's able to make necessary adjustments to either stabilize or regain the cut. Or in the case of good cutting, if that's detected, we're able to actually increase the feed rate and increase overall productivity. So not only are we going to find AI located in the cutting head, but we're going to find AI located in our 21-position nozzle changer as well. So there, AI nozzle monitor is able to track all the conditions of the nozzles in the nozzle changer and prevent processing with bad, defective nozzles, increasing productivity.
Yeah, and productivity with these fiber lasers is a big thing. It's put a lot of heat on downstream processes, and one of the things that a lot of people have looked at and tried to kind of solve the bottleneck is material handling, part sorting. Do you mind commenting on that?
Yeah, so I'd say that our automation over time has also grown with the increasing speed of today's high-power lasers. Most notably, I'd say with our MSC automation, we actually split our load and our unload gantries so that they work independently. So that's going to, you know, basically ensure the steady flow of cut and raw sheets to and from the lasers, as well as our ASCII for part sorting system. We've actually taken our tools and integrated them into the heads. Now we have 6-position tool changers and 4 independent heads, now basically allowing us to change tools on the fly and make sure we're always using the right tool for the job and doing it fast and efficiently.
Well, it sounds like important developments that metal fabricators will find very interesting. Ryan, thanks. Right now I'm going to introduce you to John Meyer. And we talked about some downstream processes, feeling the heat from these more productive fiber laser machines, 12 kilowatt, wattage is getting more powerful, parts flying out of the machine faster. Right. What type of, how have press brakes evolved to kind of handle that new pressure on the forming process?
So I would say that press brakes have evolved by becoming more user-friendly. So in the past, press brakes have been kind of the thing that were a mystery to a lot of operators. So what we've done, first of all, is we've created offline software that's made it really easy. We are reducing the amount of time that operators need to spend creating tooling setups, checking collisions, bend processes, things like that. After that, a big evolution has been controllers and controller software. So once we create a program, we need to be able to display it very easily, get that information over to the operator. And then after that's going to be automation. We're seeing it a lot more commonplace for smaller, medium-sized shops to have some type of automation, whether it be a automatic tool changer or robotics or something like that. So less large OEMs, and now it's a little bit more accessible for everyone.
Yeah, everybody's getting involved with automation. Thanks,
yep,
John.
That's right. Thank you.
Please swing by the Mitsubishi Laser booth, B as in boy, 6709, and meet the good folks here. Dan Davis signing off. Thanks.